So the presentation today is about an innovation with which we started at the Delft University of Technology in the Netherlands already in 2006. So we thought, why can we not modify the type of concrete as we have it today? And you might ask yourself the question, why would you like to modify? And that is because concrete suffers from very specific problems. And I will come to that in a minute. So first, in my first slide, I would also like to introduce my colleague, Professor Erik Slangen, who is a concrete technologist. And we met each other 12 years ago in Delft when we decided to collaborate, to combine our fields of technology, which is on the one hand concrete technology, and on the other hand microbiology, to make a new material, a self-healing material. And the idea of a self-healing material is that it has very specific properties. It can repair its own damage, of course to a certain extent, but it can repair cracks which occur during the surface life of the construction, or maybe already directly in the early phase of the casting of the construction. So we call this a smart material, self-healing. So these are a couple of images of very nice concrete constructions. For example, this is a high-performance concrete. This is a bridge from France, the Millau Bridge, which is made out of very strong, high-strength concrete. So you see this bridge, it has these columns, which have a load-bearing capacity of more than 140 megapascal. So that's why you can build very nice, slender and elegant constructions. But concrete can also be used to make infrastructure, like you see here, highway bridge, or even robust constructions like our university. This is the aula, the main office of the Delft University of Technology. But now if we zoom in the concrete, we can see, if you look close enough, you can usually see cracks. This is not only on concrete constructions, but also on pavements. I think if you walk out the door and you look at the pavement, at the floor, you will see cracks everywhere. So this is a phenomenon that is associated to concrete. Is it a problem? In some cases, yes. In some cases, not so much. If you are in a very dry environment, then usually these micro cracks are not really a problem. However, if you go to more wet environments, like we see here, then you start notice the problems that these micro cracks can result in. So we see here a basement wall, which is cracked, resulting in leakage problems. You can also see it here. This is an underground construction, parking garage, 20 meters below floor level. And because of very high groundwater pressure, we see water percolating through these micro cracks. Big problem, because the client wants to have dry feet. He doesn't want to be in a very wet environment. Another problem is what we call a durability issue. If you have open pores, open cracks, which go all the way from the concrete surface to the embedded reinforcement, we can have very early corrosion of the steel. So resulting in expansion of the steel, resulting again in spalling. So big parts of the concrete cover come off. But even worse, if these reinforcement bars are completely corroded, we will lose the tensile strength, so the tensile bearing capacity of the concrete construction, and it will collapse. So that is very dangerous, of course. So this is a phenomenon that is happening now in the United States, not in the Netherlands, because we have relatively good concrete, but I don't know if you've been to the United States. If you drive under a highway viaduct and you look up, then you become a bit scared because you see corrosion everywhere. So this is now happening on a regular basis, that constructions are collapsing. And this is because of the ongoing corrosion. So there's now one possibility to treat it, this, and this is by doing a lot of maintenance and repair. So you have to do yearly inspections of your construction to see if you see micro cracks. And if so, you need to do injections, you need to do repair. But now in Delft, that was our idea, to go up with a new invention. If we can make the concrete self-healing, then you do not need to do this manual inspections and repair. Because now we have a process embedded in the concrete that will start autonomous repair. So it will repair its own cracks, which start to occur. So if we have such a smart concrete, we can reduce the risk of failure, which is of course very important. But we also need less repair actions. And we also have less out of order occurrences. For example, if you have to repair a highway bridge, you need to close the traffic, which results in additional costs. So this really results in saving of a lot of money over the service life of the construction. So this is what we achieve with applying self-healing. We have increased performance, high performance level, high quality concrete, and we have a very long service life of the construction. Now the technology. How does the self-healing work? It is relatively simple. We just went to nature, to the environment, and see what we can learn. Now in nature, we have a lot of different types of microorganisms, and some of them are very specialized. They are bacteria, which make spores, like the seeds of plants. They are completely harmless. They are actually like probiotics. They are actually good for the health of the construction. Because what they do is they produce limestone, calcium carbonate. You can see it here under the microscope. So we have a lot of natural constructions, geological formations, which are over the millions of years produced by bacteria. Because of the precipitation of limestone, they can glue sand and gravel particles together. So that's why we have the buildup of these large formations. Now this is a process that takes a very long time in nature, and that is because these bacteria are very short in feed, in nutrients. So what we have done, we have just taken these bacteria to our lab and then investigated how can we speed up the process of limestone formation. And that's relatively easy, you just have to give them the right type of food. So this is calcium lactate. What the bacteria do, if they are in a wet, moist environment, resulting in either leakage problems or early corrosion of the reinforcement, they convert these nutrients into calcium carbonate. And with that, we can seal and waterproof cracks. Just a little bit of chemistry. So this is how it works. We have the bacteria, which become active, and then they start to convert the food, calcium lactate, to calcium carbonate, which is limestone. They use oxygen in this process. And as a byproduct, they produce some carbon dioxide, but this carbon dioxide will react with minerals which are present in the concrete matrix. We call it portlandite minerals. They will be further converted to more calcium carbonate. So we have the conversion of the food, the calcium lactate, to a lot of calcium carbonate. And in the meantime, we have consumption of oxygen. So now what do we need for self-healing? We only need the bacteria and we need the nutrients, the food. So this then results in the beneficial good processes. So on the one hand, we see that we consume the oxygen from the material. So if the material is low in oxygen, then you also have a very low risk of corrosion of the reinforcement. So it will protect the reinforcement. But at the same time, we have the process of calcium carbonate, limestone formation. You see the process happening here. So this results in improving water tightness and it decreases the porosity. So it really helps to avoid aggressive chemicals to get into the concrete, to get into the reinforcement. So now what the only thing we need to do is we need to have the bacteria, which are the catalyst of the biochemical conversion to calcium carbonate, and we need the nutrients. And then these two, we pack them together in small particles. These small particles, we call it now healing agent. And this healing agent we add to the concrete mix. So then they are all everywhere in the concrete construction. And at the moment that we have a crack formation, then we see that the bacteria will become active upon ingress of water and start to fix, seal these cracks. So over the years, we have developed different types of healing agents. And now, since 2014, we have optimized it. So we have now a very specific, very effective type of healing agent, which can be added to the concrete mix. So this is the process, what you can see on the surface of the concrete. So here we have a crack of about 1 millimeter wide. Then in moist conditions, so this is important that you need that, we will see activity of bacteria resulting in formation of limestone. It's a process that takes several weeks, but then after about 2 months, you can see that your crack has completely disappeared. Here's another image of before, micro crack and a large defect. And then after self-healing, you see because of limestone formation, you see that everything is healed, is autonomously repaired. If you now take a very close look under the microscope, so you take a little bit of this limestone, this calcium carbonate, and you make very high magnification, then you can actually see the imprints of the bacteria in the calcium carbonate. So these are active living bacteria. You can see they are shaped like a rod, a very short rod, only 2 micrometer length, about 1 micrometer diameter. And you can see the imprints here. So they precipitate all this limestone around them, and thereby they will repair, autonomously repair the cracks. Now this technology we have now converted into products. Actually 3 different products. Self-healing concrete, in which we mix the healing agent in the concrete mix. So this is for new construction, to make them self-healing. But we have also made a repair mortar, in cases you have a construction which is cracked or is damaged, then you can still implement self-healing by applying the repair mortar. And then we also have a liquid repair system. I will come to that one also in a minute. So first, I would like to show you some examples and applications of the self-healing concrete. So as I mentioned, we have the self-healing agent, so which are very small particles, diameter of about 0.5 to 1 millimeter, which are composed of the bacterial spores and the nutrients. So this we add to the concrete mix, and depending on the dosage, so how much you apply, we can have healing, autonomous healing of cracks up to about 1 millimeter wide. So this is about 5 times more than what we are allowed according to the standards and norms to have in concrete. The healing agent is very easy to apply. So it comes as a batch of small particles which you can add to the mixing truck. So this is in a concrete batching plant. These drums, they can hold about 4 cubic meter of concrete mix. So batch-wise, it is produced in the concrete plant, and then you can apply either via a silo, or you can also apply it manually. the healing agent to the mixture. And then we can make several products. We can make precast, prefabricated elements, like we did in this construction. It is a wastewater treatment reservoir made of elements of about 7 meter tall, about 3 meter wide, and 30 centimeter thick. So we have added the healing agent to this mix, made prefabricated elements, and then these elements are transported to the location and then put together to make this water reservoir. So this is during the construction phase. And here we have the same tank, but now taken into full practice. So this is doing wastewater treatment. And we have done this with the authorities who are responsible for wastewater treatment, because they told us we would like to have this demonstrator, because now we pay about 50% of our budget for maintenance and repair. So if we apply self-healing concrete, we can probably reduce maintenance and repair costs. So resulting in a lot of saving of money for the owners. This is another application. So this is the build-up of another water reservoir, very big tank, but this is now made of in situ cast concrete. So here we see the truck mixer and the pump. So here the casing, the formwork, so where they apply the material. So these are the sections, the elements of which is built up. So this is 25 meters by 5 meters and 5 meters wide. So they have that place, they cast in situ several of these elements aligned together, which in the end makes then the full water-containing reservoir. Then we also have a repair product, which I already mentioned. This is self-healing repair mortar. So with this you can repair bigger defects that you have in your currently existing construction. And this repair mortar is not only relatively strong, but it has one very important characteristic, and that is that it can deform. You can bend it. Normal repair mortars or concrete, you cannot bend, because if you overload, it will show brittle failure. So your specimen will just break in two pieces. But what you see here is actually that during the bending, you have only microcrack formation, which allows the material to deform. And this results in very specific good properties of the material. I think I missed one slide, this one. Yes, so here is my colleague again. Professor Erik Slangen, let me see if I can start this very short movie, because here he demonstrates the working of the self-healing, or actually of the deformation capacity. So he is a very strong guy, you can see that, because eventually he's able to break the material, but initially you see it bends before it breaks. So this process is also shown here. Three-point loading. And now you see that material really deforms. And that is because we added a lot of plastic, polyvinyl alcohol fibers to the mix, in addition to the concrete healing agent. So now we have deformation. And if you look very closely, you can see here a lot of very small microcracks. So instead of brittle failure, getting one very big crack, we get hundreds of very small ones. And these are very easy to self-repair when you apply healing agents. So with this material, we can make a very nice protective layer on top of your concrete surface. So it is ductile, it's flexible, so it can move a little bit. So in case of earthquakes, or in case of crack formation of the underlying concrete, then you will see that the top layer deforms with it. So it only makes the very small microcracks, which are then easily self-healed, giving very good protection of the underlying concrete. So here are a few pictures of applications. It is a structural repair mortar. So if you have defects, for example on your column, you have a lot of spalling and corrosion happening, then you remove the cover layer, then you inspect the rebars, you clean them, maybe you need to replace them when they are very poor shape, but then you can apply the repair mortar. So you apply it here, and you can see it's also easy to finish. It's one possibility. Another possibility is the problem that I showed before in these basement walls, which are very leaky, then you buy manual repair. Oh, what's happening? By manual repair, you just have to cut open the small cracks so you provide the repair mortar with a larger surface area. Then you apply it, and then also you finish it. And then you can stop all these leakage problems you have in your basement or in your underground tunnel or anywhere where you have leakage issues with your material. You can also apply it as a liner on top of material which is degraded, so over time, maybe aged concrete, which became very porous and therefore also shortening the surface life of construction, you can apply as a finish. But you can also apply as a shotcrete this material, spraycrete. So if you have to treat large surfaces, like here you see all this leakage here, then you do by shotcreting, you can apply it, and relatively quickly you can repair large surfaces. So we have made specific YouTube video, so if you are able to get to this presentation, maybe I will make it available. If you're at home and you look at this, you will see a movie how the repair mortar is actually applied as a shotcrete. But then we also have a third product, which we call liquid repair system, ER7. The application of the liquid is also for concrete constructions, which are just a little bit damaged. So they are suffering still only from micro cracks, which need to be repaired. Otherwise, cracks will get bigger and bigger, more and more leakage problems, more and more risk of reinforcement corrosion. So then you can apply this material, it comes in a powder, you just dissolve it in water, and then you can apply it as a spray on the existing surface. So this is our scientist who has developed this material. It comes in two components, which we call A and B, and when you apply them simultaneously, so one after the other, in sequence, then you will get a gel formation. And this gel will be converted in limestone in a few weeks or days' time. But the advantage is that after applying this material, you can immediately reuse your surface. For example, in a basement wall or in a parking garage, you can open the parking garage again, so you can again make money. And the application is very fast. So we can treat about, in several demonstrators we have done this, 6,000 square meters, we can treat it in 4 hours' time. So all the cracks that you have can then be treated. Now this helps to increase also the density of the material, so it also reduces the ingress of these harmful chemicals. Now with this treatment, with this material, we can seal micro cracks of 0.2 millimeter with one treatment. And if your micro cracks are bigger, then you need to repeat the treatment maybe 2 or 3 times, but then at least you get complete waterproofing, sealing of your cracks. Few applications, again, so this is a very specific type of construction. Our architect, he designed this to have to feature a very thin shell concrete of only 6 centimeters, but during its production, it heavily cracked. So it became already leaking before the construction was actually handed over to the owner. So then they had to do repair. So this is where we then applied the liquid. You can see it, you can do manual application easily because this is a relatively small construction. And then it results in sealing of the surface. But you can also apply it, what we have done several times in, for example, on parking decks, which are heavily cracked, and because the cars bring in a lot of water, So you will have leakage to underlying floors. So there you can also do manual treatments by using these containers with the pressure, then you can spray. And here you see the effect. This is a big crack which is treated with the material. So you see here this gel formation, and this gel is then converted into limestone after just a few days. So then after a few hours, the parking garage can be reopened, and then so the owner can still then continue earning money. So otherwise he has to close the parking garage and section by section do manual repair, which takes usually several weeks, but now he can be finished, done in only one day. So if you have a very large surface area like this one, then manual work takes a long time. So then you can also use this just regular cleaning machines. So these cleaning machines, they usually can hold up to 1,000 liters of water. So in this case, we applied here the repair system. So component A and component B. So the first one drives out and he just brushes the liquid into the micro cracks. Second one follows and he finishes, resulting in gel formation. And after that, you do just one cleaning event, and then your parking garage, it can be reopened again. Here again, you see limestone formation by the bacteria. And this is to show how durable the material actually becomes. There's one test which can show the durability, so how good repairs actually are. And this is a laboratory test which you call freeze and thaw test. So you first do a treatment of your material, and if you have then densification of your cover and you expose it to freezing and thawing events, then usually you see spalling on the surface, so parts of the matrix come off. So the amount of spalling is a measure for the reduction in durability, so how long the surface life of your material will be. And in this case, we have taken in this from this parking garage, which we have treated. We have taken several drilled cylinder cores from parts which were treated and parts which were not treated, that did this freeze and thaw cycles. And then you can see that just after one treatment, you already have 50% reduction of spalling. So a major increase in durability of your material.